I call this meeting to order at 7:01. Can you please rise for the pledge of allegiance?
I pledge allegiance
to the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Starting off with the agenda is the approval of the minutes from last Senate meeting. Are there any questions in the minutes? Seeing no questions or discussion, we're going to move to the approval of tonight's agenda. Any questions or concerns about tonight's agenda? Seeing no questions or concerns, we're going to move on to the President's report. Just a reminder real quick is please use the student concern form, that Google form that I sent out, I think it was a month ago now. If you have any concerns that are on campus, this could be anything from residents' life to the food to the shuttles aren't moving fast enough to parking, anything on your chest that you want to get off, please send it in with the student concern form. If you need it again, please just send us an email at sga@rowan.edu or my own sga@rowan.edu, and I will send you the Google form once again. Real quick, as a summary, I had a meeting with the Wellness Center and Dr. Rubenstein in the Wellness Center last Monday, and it's very phenomenal improvements that the Wellness Center has been able to do over the past four or five couple of years, that they're going to be coming next semester and speaking about different changes and things they've been working on. But a couple of those things, and we've been recognized, I know regionally, of how successful our services have been. But one detail of those services, please take a visit to the Wellness Center. It's pretty amazing. The amount of services they're providing to us as Rowan students on the budget they're working on, and that compared to the amount of students that are on this campus. And then one last thing is shuttle stops. So we've been working, obviously this has been a hot topic, and we'll be talking about a little bit later is the proposal I've written for all of you, is our shuttle system and services on campus. I'm going to provide our summary of what we think the best shuttle route is with John Adorento, who works with the shuttle services, next Senate meeting, with a nice, pretty picture with red stars. I showed the e-board tonight, and we made a few changes to try to best accommodate time and the amount of stops spread out throughout campus. So I'm going to just provide it to you all next Senate meeting. So if you want to make any changes, please come forward right after that Senate meeting, and then we can sit down and maybe make those changes. We thought about it very detailed and saw all the numbers coming in. So there are hard decisions to be made, but ultimately I think we're going to have a really, really improved shuttle system next semester, and it'll look real good, hopefully. So that's just a few notes on my president's report. Is there any questions for me at this moment? Well, moving on to open session, President Buschmann.
Everyone, good evening and welcome back to the campus. I hope all of you had a wonderful time during Thanksgiving with your family. Just want to give you a quick update about the state of the university and if there are any questions I'll be happy to answer. The buildings are moving along and we expect by January both business college and engineering building will be ready, so there will be a lot of moving there. Also, we have built an extension to Camden campus that will be open next week. A3 building, which is Road Boulevard, is very, very important for you because when that building is completed by next August, not only do we have an additional 500 dorm room, but also there will be a large additional rec center built there, almost as big as this, if not bigger, as well as big chunk of communication college will move into A3 building. We are renting one week, five floors, so that they can move to a much better and much more appropriate facility. And soon after that, and also the parking lot, there's a 900 garage parking that will be open every January in Britain. So hopefully you guys, we no longer have parking issues. I recognize this year we have challenges in parking. I recognize many of you were frustrated, but you have to understand that we have grown so very fast during the last 6-7 years in here. Having you wonderful people coming in here and when you apply, especially if you are a New Jersey citizen, it's very difficult to say no. So we have grown by over 7,000 students in 6 years. That is probably the largest growth in the nation. I don't know of any other institution. So as a result of this massive growth, in some of the areas, we have had shortages and we are taking care of those. Very certainly one of them, the food services, as you know, in Hollywood Common, they have a beautiful cafeteria. And the most important thing for you guys is the additional dorm and parking. And then the next project that we have in place of Linden Hall is currently the one that we have some water problems, you know about the debt problem. That we intend to demolish it. And hopefully over the next year or two, we will build a 6- or 7-story classroom / lab building so that people don't have to walk far away to get to the classroom. So this is the state of the building. A lot of activities are going in here. The institution is in great shape. Financially, we are fine. We are hiring many more faculty members. And I want you to know that my commitment regarding the tuition and fee increase remains for as long as I'm here. It will never go beyond the rate of inflation as we see it. Regarding the state of the university, I just wanted to say how incredibly proud and respectful I am of all of you in the way that you behaved post-election. I recognize this was a challenging election. There were people on both sides, and there were emotions involved, but the way that you conducted yourself, the way you express yourself, I'm extremely proud. Compared to many other institutions, I really consider you a group of grown-up, mature people. So for that, you should pat yourself on the shoulder. And the fact that I come in here and I see this many of you being here at 7 in the evening, caring about your affairs, makes me feel very good. So with that, I just like to answer any questions.
Any questions?
When the engineering and business college, especially business college, where we are the advanced hall, we're going to move all of them to the building. So we intend to turn the entire advanced hall across boards into administration, including people who are in service. Service is very common academic. We're going to renovate it and think about classrooms and that, so that everybody will be centered located in that one business. So the students, if they have issues, they can go to a one-stop shop. I don't want you to go to one place for bursar, one place for registrar, one place for housing. There's just one location that is much easier, much more convenient. And given that was the initial, the original building of the university, and it really needs a lot of complexity. It is no longer good for a high-tech classroom. That's what we're going to take at that position. That's what we're going to do. Yes? Yes, it's going to be, we are basically, for me, the quality of life for you guys is of paramount importance. Really is. I don't want you to number one live in places that are low quality. And some of our northern dorms are really live their useful lives. And that's another project. We're going to get a lot of more replacements. So we're going to make sure that as we move along, every one of these facilities are going to be much more modern, air conditioning. Because to me, I need to seriously look at the possibility of keeping the university open over the summer. Through a 3-year degree program, for example, that we have. I would love those who can handle a 3-year degree to get a 4-year completely free. No tuition, no fee, no room. But you get all that. If you study hard and if you take the number of credits, you can literally get a lower degree by paying 3 years of tuition. So, in order for me to get the quality of life up for you, facilities are very important. working with Glassboro to make sure that the public safety and the police are in good relationship with you is very important. Making sure that you have places where you can go and actually have fun as young people. You have every right to have that. It's very important. Having a facility where you can have play, like the field that we just spent more than $2 million on the service. Those are important because these are the best years of your life, and you cannot expect you just to come in there, go to the classroom, get your homework and go home and sleep. There is life after that. So for all of those reasons, I really do want to see every one of these facilities are modern, they're air conditioned, they're clean, and they're available to all of them. So the A3 actually is going to be very fascinating. It's not going to be just one building, there are going to be five buildings. And then A4 is going to be even more exciting. A4 is actually as we started with it, we are pouring concrete. So by the time that this place is done, that Rowan Boulevard is going to be the most amazing place in the way of my life. Because we're going to close that road, we're going to have it a place where people can just walk in and out, still up and out, be safe, go to restaurants, go to the bar, we're going to build an art gallery so that our students and faculty, arts and products can be showcased and sold. So really it's going to be a very, very different campus. I'm sorry for the senior people, but freshmen guys, we're going to have fun over the next 4 years. Anybody else?
Thank you, Dr. Mishra.
Thank you, sir.
Next up on our open session is Howard Luber. All right, moving on to Joe Egan and Leadership Round.
All right, everyone stand up real quick. All right, come on, stand up. No, I'm serious, please stand real quick, this will be fun. All right, everybody standing. All right, you pretty much have to do what I do. We're going on a roller coaster. All right?
Go.
Strap in. All right, lean back. I'm Joe Egan.
I'm
Ashley. We're from Leadership Round, part of the OSLB office. All right, so our goal.
Through this program of Leadership Takeout, our goal is to increase campus wide involvement in club growth and development and help clubs grow through active participation and engaging presentation. So basically, what that means is being a part of a club is sort of really integral part of being a college student, and I think that most of you guys here would agree with me. And so our goal for Leadership Takeout is to take our clubs and make them great. People like to be a part of clubs, but they really like to be a part of great clubs. So our goal is to give you guys some leadership energizers, activities, icebreakers to make your clubs great.
So what we do, so we deliver leadership programs to you. So the reason it's called Leadership Takeout is because it works like a takeout food company. So you contact us, and we have a menu set up. There's a bunch of appetizers, entrees, and some specials. So whether you're not, and we kind of cater it towards each organization. So we don't just sell one thing. If you call us up and you're like, hey, my club, we're really organized, but we don't have that much fun. Then we'll come in, we'll do some fun icebreakers, some fun presentations, and get you guys a little more excited. Be like, hey, like our club, we have a great time, like we all enjoy it, but we're not too organized. Then we have presentations for you for that. Or come in and we'll discuss organizational strategies and really any way to get your club to improve your clubs.
Happy to talk with you guys if you guys have fun stuff to share.
care. You should care because we care about it. We really want to have clubs grow, and like we really love, like I love clubs. I wish I could be in every club. Can't, because we have to go to class. But I really love clubs, and I really want to like help clubs grow because people, I love being part of clubs. And like, you know, you're in a club, you're like, like the clubs could get better. We really want to help clubs grow and help clubs like in all aspects. We want to have a good time. I really, we just did that roller coaster thing. I don't know if you guys loved it. I loved it. You know, we want to improve your clubs. And you know, once you're in a good club, you can kind of improve yourselves. So, you know, we want to just keep on growing people, growing leaders to make clubs better and make everyone's campus-wide involvement feel a little more stronger and love growing a little bit more. More information. So this Wednesday in the Owl's Nest, 6:30 p.m. we have a little promo party. So we'll be doing more ice makers like that, some fun things. We'll have a couple presentations, some mock presentations, and a good Q&A session, and really explain to you how Takeout will work, and really answer any questions. And we'll have some food there, and it'll be a good fun time. 6:30 in the Owl's Nest, and hope you all can make it. Does anyone have any questions now?
Any questions for Joe or Ashley or Ed?
We're Leadership Rowan, which runs through the OSFP office. So if you have any more questions about Leadership Takeout, so Charlie, like if you're looking into ordering things, like how that works, more presentations, things we offer, more like direct contact. Yes.
How long is the promo party around for?
I would say 6:30 to 8 is our normal block.
Does the Takeout come with fries?
I don't think so. Anybody else?
Any other questions? Thank you, Leadership Row.
Thank you.
Now we're going to move on to our executive announcements, starting with Student Trustee Melissa.
I want to thank everybody who completed the survey. We had about 500 responses, and they were very, very thorough, and they're going to go a long way in helping us as an executive board better serve you as a student body. Like we promised, we're giving out 10 t-shirts to random winners, so be on the lookout for your email tonight. They're very, very soft, and they're very, very bright. In addition to seeing those very thoughtful responses to the survey, I'm going to be sending out another email to organize focus groups. If you feel really passionate about something that you send us in the survey response, we want you to come sit down with us one-on-one and let us know. So be on the lookout for that email as well. All right, that's it.
Any questions for Arbery? Moving on to AVP of Club Development, Riley.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Riley Shea, the AVP of Club Development. I just want to let everybody know that the Club Development Committee meeting will be taking place next Monday in the SJA suite at 7 p.m. Thank you.
Any questions for Riley? Moving on to Vice President Nicole.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nicole Santos, the Executive Vice President of SJA. I just wanted to remind you all that Club of the Month for November is on PropLink, so go out and nominate your clubs for Club of the Month. Get a $40 voucher for any meeting of your choice for pizza, and you also get a free award and some recognition on social media. it takes about 2 minutes to fill out, and it's a really easy way to avoid getting 2 points. So fill out the quarterly progress report, student summary. Any questions?
Moving on to CFO Jason.
Something to know, I know you are not all treasurers or maybe you have no interest in money, but your club has to operate some way, some fashion. And so for the clubs that hire off campus or even on campus talent or perhaps you want a motivational speaker, then you really need to provide a contract for them. And so whoever you are paying money to, and if they're providing you a service, you must give them a contract that's from Rowan University. If they're a student, if they're a faculty member, if they are just a vendor from a business off campus, you really need one. Some vision, and it doesn't really stay up there, but one vision that I have that I hopefully want to implement by the end of the year is to have some way for clubs to come into the SGA office and they can flip through a book of student talent. Maybe they're DJs, motivational speakers, like I said. Really anyone who has a service that they want to provide, and that the clubs who are local or the clubs that are SGA chartered that have funds that want to hire someone for a specific purpose, they can easily look through the book and see, okay, who's that person? Maybe they have some reviews from people who hired their services prior to that, and they have some good things, or maybe not so good things to say. All of those things, hopefully, maybe one day will be instructed and put into a book. But for now, we don't have that. So if there is any interest from student talent out there who would like to have this become a thing, email me, sjacfo@rowan.edu. I have my business card up here as well. That includes phone number, office phone number, and every other information you need to know to contact me. You're able to do that. So, but really the main thing for now is if you have one of those off-campus people that you want to bring on, you really need a contract. So tell your treasurer about that before planning anything. Don't have them go to your meeting and do a lesson for a service and then not being able to be paid for probably a month after that because the proper process was not go through. So please communicate with your board members on that. Thank you.
Any questions for Jason? AVP of Academic Affairs, Danielle.
Hi everyone. As you know, earlier this month we were taking scholarship applications. So it did close about 2 weeks ago. So we had over 150 applications for the SGA scholarship, and they are under review right now. So I just want to thank everyone who came out last Monday to help read all 150 of them. If you apply for the scholarship or know a friend who applied for the scholarship, winners will be announced on December 15th. So look out for that on December 15th if you did apply for the SGA scholarship. Also, if you're interested in coming to the Academic Affairs Committee meetings, there will be one next Monday at 7 and 1:27. We're moving past scholarships now and on to other stuff if you want to come join now. And then also, all of my senators who have not gotten polos, let's get you polos after this meeting so we can all wear them next meeting. Thanks.
Any questions for Danielle? Moving on to the AVP of Student Affairs, Naveen.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, we all love the popcorn, so let's give Bowman Dad a quick round of applause. My I would just like to address a concern that was left in the Student Affairs concern box sometime about 2 weeks ago. The concern reads, there is never anyone in the office when I need forms approved. I always have to wait for them to come back. Just a reminder that our office hours are 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. During that time, Tara Sabatini will most likely be available. If not, our Captain Keeley or one of us APPs or Christy or any one of us sitting up here should be there Monday through Friday. Please take note of these office hours because we tried our best to reach out to everyone's needs and we're really upset that we couldn't help whoever came in. If there's any concerns that we can't address because it's outside of our regular office hours, just email sga@rowan.edu. So now we're going to play the hoop. So Student.it. And once you're out of the website, you can enter the student 0865. The Wi-Fi working today, you guys?
Moving on to the AVP University Advancement, Kevin.
There's a bunch of events. Everyone will get it in their own announcer.
If you have any questions, you can email sjaadvancement@rum.edu. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. There's also a, if you want to be involved in our service trip, we're going to Camden Cathedral Kitchen. We have a few more slots left open. So if you would like to be a part of that, there's a prop link on Rum SGA. You can be a part of it. All you have to do is spell out a few questions, not that hard, acknowledging that you represent the face of Rum University while at Cathedral Kitchen, and understanding that there is a dress code for Cathedral Kitchen. As far as everything else goes, I can explain anything if you guys have any questions. Like I said, email me. Look forward to seeing you guys all out there. We just look forward to the success of all these events. And I hope you guys see this beneficial to campus, something we'll continue in the future, and you guys are happy with all the work that we put forward.
Any questions for Kevin? Moving on to the Director of PR and Special Events, Sarah.
Hi everyone. So for Holiday Week, which starts next week, as Kevin just explained, we're going to be running a gift card promotion. So basically, you'll be seeing more information about this on social media, but if you attend these events, Holiday Week events, and if you tag Holiday Week 2016, you'll be entered in a drawing for a $25 gift card. So keep an eye out for that. We'll be starting work on a Snapchat for Rowan SGA. Keep an eye out for that also. Hope to have that up and running very soon. And if you have not followed these social media accounts, please feel free to do so because we have a lot of announcements on there. That's where you can tag pictures for Holiday Week and just keep updated. And if you have any questions or anything like that, you can send messages to those accounts, so feel free to follow those if you have not already. Thanks.
Any questions for Sarah? AVP of Facilities Operations, Beth.
Hi guys, no report for tonight from me.
Reporting Secretary Tiffany.
Hi everyone, just make sure you sign in at the end of the meeting and check your folders for the Senator Winchell things that were put in last week if you didn't pick them up. If you happen to not get one, come see me after the meeting. I have a couple more. And then there's also another survey that you guys should fill out once they invite you.
Is there any questions for Tiffany? Real quick, in all of your folders, you should be there should be a survey. Can you please fill that? I know it's all shuttle bus related all the time, but please fill that out. And as you're handing your folder back into Tiffany or whatever SGA representative is standing there, please hand that separately to the individual collecting the folders. All right. Moving on to new business, I'm going to ask CFO Jason to speak.
Okay, so hopefully all of you are aware by now of what supplemental requests are. They are just additional funding in case your charter organization determines that there's not enough funds, that there's an emergency, maybe you have a one-time expense, maybe you have an expense that's unforeseen, and these are all characteristics of what you might be able to apply for the supplemental request. So we received three requests last week. Again, any of you can apply, you just have to have the appropriate situation. But today we have to determine whether or not a club is receiving funds, and that's up to senators. So we'll be voting at the end of this. So before we can vote on this, every application has to go through the Student Financial Control Board. It's comprised of six students, five voting members, made up of class academic senators and AVPs, as well as myself. So the group in, under scrutiny today is Pre-Allied Health Club. So is the treasurer or president or any representative here?
Yeah, I'm just the SGA representative.
Can you answer any questions if there are?
Yeah, absolutely. Basically, we're in need of supplemental funds. Last year, we weren't approved for a budget. There was a little falling out with our board because there was some miscommunications that happened, and there was no one going to the SGA meetings, and our treasurer actually dropped out, so there's no one that went to our budget meeting. Since then, we've stepped up our game. We've completely built a new e-board for Allied Health, and we have a bunch of really new and exciting plans for the club. And so as you can see on the board, we're asking for a total of $1,200. I feel like the best way to present this to you is by explaining a little bit about Reality Health and what we do. Basically, we provide access for students who are looking to go into the peripheral health fields, like physical therapy, physician's assistant, occupational therapy, nursing, dentistry, you name it. We provide them with communication and information for graduate school programs. And so if you take a look at what we're asking the money for, we do a number of trips to graduate schools for all those different fields of peripheral healthcare. So the first subject is asking for $435 for bus rentals to transport members to and from graduate school visits. This is way more expensive than we thought, but we have a few visits planned, and we really need the money for this because this is what really connects the 250 members of Reality Health to the graduate schools that they want to see. What we also do is we have a lot of graduate schools admission boards come in and give presentations about whatever the graduate school is. And what we do is we'll take them out to lunch just as a good representation of Verona University as a whole and our club. And so for that, we're asking for $250 because we have a ton of them that we set up. The next subject is asking for $150 for a day of mock interviews with freshmen. Now we can set this up with the school, and the total cost is $150. And we're planning a club clothing sale. And for that, we need something to back up. We need funds to back up the money that we're going to be making back for the club as a fundraising effort. So we're asking for $300 for that. And I wasn't in Reality Health for this last bit, and I didn't even know this was a thing. But we have an outstanding Nick's Pizza purchase order for $65. So we're asking for money for that. There's 250 members in our club, and it's really great what we do for them. It's really helpful to connect them to graduate schools to continue their career. So allowing these funds, it really helps us do our job and help students connect to what they're going to be doing in the future. Thanks.
There were a few things that SOCP had to consider because we have to go by our guidelines that's been redrafted, edited every year. But there are set rules, procedures, there's a process for this application. As I mentioned, SOCP reviewed this. And there were a few things that we had to not consider because they were against those stipulations. So for example, and I'm sorry that you had to read all of that, but the club clothing sale, clubs are not able to use SGA funds. So you can use your fundraising account for this, but you cannot use SGA funds to purchase items or service and then turn it around to make a profit, because that's like double taxing a student, because students are the ones who are funding SGA. So we cannot consider the closing sale because you are turning that around and making a profit off of that. The other thing is the outstanding mixed pizza purchase order. It was last year, and unfortunately, I was unfortunate because they can't afford it because of last year's e-board. So they are under new leadership, but unfortunately, we cannot consider it as a mixed pizza order because that is an expense that's been incurred already. We can't provide additional funding for clubs that have already spent that money. You can do that. You are under consideration if you know you have an expense that needs to be paid. That's cutting it pretty close, though, if you have to get this approved, so I don't suggest that. But you know, if you are under that emergency, that deadline, and you do have the time to do it, you can. But this consideration, or this instance, you can't think of the $65 to add to it. So we were a little confused with SFCB on what the mock interviews, the amounts, and the graduate school visits were. The details in this application weren't enough for us to determine a full amount of $435 plus $250. We did account that perhaps a carpooling and mileage reimbursement might have been preferable in this case, in which we offered $150 for for the carpooling and mileage as an alternative, $50 for the mock interview refreshment, the sales, the graduate school admissions officer food, and an additional $100 for the mock interview supplies. So that adds up to $300 that we are looking to offer that. That is our suggestion with SFCB. But now this is the time for the senators to discuss what they want to do with that information. If they want to decrease that amount, if they want to add more, it's really up to you guys. So if you have anything that you want to discuss before a vote, you may come to one of these two mics. Otherwise, we'll vote on $300. That's what they requested. Out of my head. It's not up there. This is their request.
$300.
So again, it's $150 instead of $435. It's $50 for the lunch rather than $250. And it was $50 for the sale. For the interviews. $150, $150.
I have one quick question for you. About how many people for each of these events do you transport, and how many of these events per year do you have?
We typically have about 3 per semester, 6 per year. And what number of students actually go is
really please come forward. Rewind, just kidding. JK. All right. Next, real quick, Jason has a little amendment change.
Hey, good guys. So remember last Senate we had to change something? Well, we're doing it again. The change is actually a much beneficial thing. We're not doing this to the church anyone. We made a mistake. Rather, I take it, I made a mistake when I did the amendment last time, which was I considered the primary aspect that we were trying to do, which was to make this a little bit more of a universal amendment. And when doing so, the old figures of 67 and 33% made the discrepancy larger than it really was. So with this amendment of changing 67 to 57 and 33 to 43 respectively, we're trying to make this a little bit more fair to this e-board to future e-board members, and really anyone who is interested in applying for these positions, because with that amendment that we did last Senate meeting, it became an unfair, imbalanced bylaw. So I want to make sure that this is more balanced by reducing that discrepancy to an agreeable amount. So SFCB determined that this was an appropriate change. If you have questions, please let me know now. Any questions? All right, I'm passing off the mic to student trustee.
We have three quick last new businesses. It's one more petitioning club, a secondary education club. Please come forward.
Charter.
That is mine. That's my fault.
It's all on both.
Charter. The big time.
Logistics and supply chain management is going to be a brand new major here at Roan starting next semester, and we're just kind of starting the club up for that specific major to bring more presence to it on campus. In addition, APIC's provides excellent, like an excellent opportunity for students to be involved with a professional organization. It allows us as students to get an outside look on things. So currently we have about 17 members, and but our major has now grown to a little over 50 people, so we're hoping that this number grows next semester. We're currently having one meeting a month, and actually it was a couple weeks ago we had a joint thing with the Princeton South Jersey chapter, which is the professional side of it, that we teamed up with them, actually had a meeting with them and learned about mission critical logistics, which was very interesting. And then, so what the funding would go to from SGA, basically APIX allows, they have case competitions that we would definitely like to be a part of, and just getting guest speakers to come talk to us. And then lastly, just our plans for giving back to Rome. I'm definitely gonna, we're still looking at options for service projects, and hopefully we can get involved with maybe a food bank or something like that.
Is there any questions?
So supply chain management, for those who don't know it, is basically it's getting the actual product from being from point of origin to point of consumption. Yes. So it's basically, I like to say it's like basically all the moving parts, most of the moving parts in business world. We just make sure they just keep rolling through and get the product to the customer.
Any other questions?
Just one clarification. You said that the major that is going to be representing will be on campus in the future, not currently.
So currently, supply chain management is a concentration. It's a business administration with a concentration in supply chain management and logistical systems. And then next semester, in February, I believe, that's when I'll go from a concentration to an actual full major.
Any other questions? Can anyone affiliated with Supply Chain Management Club please leave the room at this time?
Congratulations. I usually look good. Congratulations.
We did it. All right. I know this might be the last time you hear me talk about the shuttle. This is it right here. So now this is the actual proposal that the E Board came up with, because it's a significant amount of money, right? So people ask, oh, where are you going to get this money from? So there's a fund balance SGA has, almost a reserve account where everything was left over. I mean, Jason can talk about it more, where we can pull the money from. It's this fund balance. So here's a proposal to pull from the fund balance. And I'll read. This is a resolution for the purchase of shuttle bus vehicle wraps for the improvement of branding the shuttle services at Rome University. The author is us. Whereas Rome University Student Government Association is responsible for meeting the needs of current and future students of Rome University, and whereas the current Rome University shuttle services are underutilized and indistinguishable from other shuttle services in South Jersey area, and whereas wrapping the internal shuttle services of shuttle vehicles would improve the visibility of the shuttle services and enhance student transportation experience, and whereas part of Rowan's SGA's mission is to investigate solutions to various issues that affect the campus as a whole, and whereas the shuttle services provided by the university is to benefit student life and accommodate student transportation, all while supporting student parking and transit, therefore let it be resolved
the Rowan SGA will purchase 4 shuttle bus vehicle routes for a maximum of $20,000 from the SGA fund balance to be installed on Rowan University internal shuttle service vehicles. One more time, and I'll answer a question real quick. Can you show the owners finalized because of their logos? We did change the back. Remember I presented before and had the back, and I wanted to change one more time. So then there's the new back. It's one of those two, depending on where. The company's logos, SJTA's logos, will be going on the sides and back. But that's what you will see January 17th if everything works out tonight. Any questions?
Once this fund study is taken out with the balance, what would be left of the fund balance? What numerical value?
That's a good question. We cannot know. Jason, you know?
We have $300.
What?
$300.
Yes, a lot of money. A lot of money will be left in that fund balance. Do you have any big ideas? Any other questions? Oh, Jason.
Just a side note, the fund balance is the accumulation of unspent money from the clubs and from SGA every year. It just accumulates, and it's supposed to be used for the benefit of the university and the student body. It's supposed to happen very rarely, so this is one case. It's supposed to have between $450,000 and $750,000.
Question in the back?
Yes. So you said those buses, it was $20,000 for 4 of them?
So to rack, it's not to buy.
I was about to say.
Right, so we outsource that shuttle service right now to SJTA at this point in time. So those white ones that you see with the circle logo, they're SJTA. We have a contract with them. So this is to rack those shuttle buses. Now I asked the representative of SJTA during our meeting, how frequent will we see these? Because I don't know if you all know, during shuttle services, buses actually have to rest, your rest period during their time of activity. And he said 95% of the time you will see this.
Okay.
Any other questions? So I would entertain a motion. There's been a motion to approve this resolution. Is there a second? All 4, please raise your placards. Thank you, again. Resolution passes. Thank you so much. All right, so there's one last resolution for the night. Not many people know him, but he's a long-term family member of the Rowan University community. So during the Board of Trustees, this actually happened, and this will happen to actually Melissa down here at the end of the tables together. This will actually, the Board of Trustees will go through the same resolution when Melissa graduates this coming May. So this is a resolution just to recognize the efforts of Jim Lovegrove. So I'll read it out loud real quick. Resolution to recognize the retirement of former SGA president and assistant vice president of operations and plant management, James Lovegrove. So he's right now the assistant vice president of operations and plant management. To what? So the authors are the Student Government Association Executive Board. So, whereas James Lovegrove has made a remarkable impact to the Rowan University, Rowan community during and after his studies here at Rowan University, whereas he was a former president of the Student Government Association and participated in student activities, and whereas during his professional roles in residence life, administration and finance, and in facilities and operations, whereas he has represented the student body of this university in an exemplary manner. Therefore, be it resolved, we acknowledge with deep appreciation his dedication efforts on behalf of the student population and congratulate him and wish him well in all future endeavors. So this is just a recognition resolution. We'll probably be sending it to him. It's just out of respect of an individual that was an early SGA president. I would say, I think it's, he was one of the first 20 SGA presidents, actually right after Gene Edelman. So he followed Gene Edelman, the one that donated the $25 million. He was the SGA president directly after her. So he made some great impact and grew this organization into part of what it is today. So, is there a motion?
Motion.
Second? All four, please raise your card. Against? Resolution passed. Thank you so much. At this point in time, is there any senator concerns? If you have any general announcements, can you please step forward right here and take the mic from me? Any general announcements? Anything fun happening? No? Going on.
The International Club this semester has been my support. We haven't done like a lot of things, so the roller coaster guy, we might need you in our club. So on Friday, the International Club is actually open to everyone, you know, international students, American students. The wrong notion is that it's exclusive for international, but it's actually open to everyone. So on Friday, December 2nd, here, we'll be having our first general meeting. That's going to be actually more like general eating, like food and drinks. And everybody should come. Yeah, because we want to promote our club, but you know we're dying this semester. But next semester, you know, we'll probably be back. You're going to hear a lot of from us next semester. There's all going to be more vacancies, so we'll have a question this Friday.
Yeah. Yeah, no announcement. Good job, Al.
Thank you. We've got all the model lineup here for
the BioChem Club is having a resume workshop. It's this Friday at 2 o'clock in Science 128. It's open to all majors. It's probably more helpful if you're something in the sciences because the person hosting it works for a scientific company. So she's also going to be answering some questions. That's this Friday, 2 o'clock, in Science 128.
Right.
So the Student History Association and Phi Alpha Theta are holding a plan drive right now in the Spectator Floor History Department with Gina Hodgson. It's going on for the next week. Please join your hand, Kimberly Hand, and Maria Dollar, and anything else on the thing here.
Roman Out Jubilee Prop Pack. It's a hackathon, 24 hours of food, fun, and prizes. Come on out.
When?
Good question. Registration opens very soon. We don't have an exact date, but sometime early December. Look for the event in early February. I'll give you more details as we go closer.
Who likes animals?
I do.
Who likes giving? Who has an over-excessive amount of pet treats, pets, food, and or poor toys because of Thanksgiving and must get rid of them in order to avoid a catastrophe?
Me.
You said yes to any of these, especially the third one. Come down to the library where Anime Club is actually holding a donation drive for the animal shelter. Bring anything. Pet food, pet toys. I don't care what there is. If you love to give to animals, they'll take it. And remember, think of the puppies.
Aww. Is there a motion?
One second, hurry up.
So I'll make this real quick, so we can have Just go over the what the forms were. There was a form to go to the campus presentation. There's also another form for any clubs, organizations, or individuals who like to form for the SNL Stands Karaoke Night, which would be Tuesday, December 6th. Mind you, the holiday week is next week, so like I said, this is going to be after the Rumble Commission, the Rumble after. But just to show you guys where it's at, it's under the Student Government Association on Frontline, under Forms. And then this is the SNL Skit Karaoke sign-ups. From there, you'll be placed in your position. Anywhere you any information that you want to attach additionally, you can attach my form. And then there's also the SGA Holiday Week service trip, so that's there too. Both of them are up. The one closes on Wednesday, 11:45 p.m. The 7th, the other one's the 6th. So please make this an effort if you want to. And mind you that if you are a part of both of these, you'll be entering a chance to win a prize. Well, yeah, entering a chance to win a prize and gift card.
Motion.
Motion.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes.